हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू वीडियो लेक्चर ऑन मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस हियर मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस ऑन मैग्नेटोस्टैटिक्स। इन फर्स्ट पार्ट आई हैड ऑलरेडी डिस्कस सम मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस। नाउ इन दिस पार्ट आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस रिमेनिंग मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस। लेट अस टेक फर्स्ट मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन। The ability of magnetic field to magnetize a material medium is called. So suppose B is magnetic field, and in that magnetic field, suppose we place magnetic material. The magnetic material is magnetized. So the B has ability to magnetize material, and that ability is called as magnetic intensity H. So here it is second one is correct. Its magnetic intensity H. The relation between magnetic intensity and magnetic induction in free space is, since free space there is no magnetization, the magnetic intensity and magnetic induction are related by this equation, B is equal to mu 0 into H. So this second one is correct. Now we know unit of B, it is Weber per meter square. Mu 0, this is Weber per ampere meter. So what is unit of H? So if we find Weber per meter square is equal to Weber ampere meter into unit of H, you will get unit of H. That is ampere per meter. So you may ask question on unit of magnetic intensity. For next one, for most magnetic materials, the magnetization M is. So when magnetic material is placed in the magnetic field, it is magnetized. And whatever magnetization of that material, it is proportional to ability, that is magnetic intensity. More is the intensity, more is the magnetization. So M is directly proportional to H. So here if we see four alternatives, first one always proportional to the magnetic field intensity as 1 upon H. So this is incorrect. Always proportional to curl of H. This is incorrect. Always proportional to magnetic field intensity. This is correct. Always proportional to B cross H. This is incorrect. Now next one. The relation between three vectors B, H and M for the magnetic material is given as. Means here there is magnetic field B. Magnetic material is placed in the field and that material is magnetized. So M is magnetization, H is magnetic intensity which produces magnetization, and B is magnetic induction. They are related by this equation, B is equal to mu 0 H plus M in the bracket. So here relation is B is equal to mu 0 in bracket H plus M. This one is correct. Second, B is equal to mu 0 H plus M. So here what? M is separate one. So B is equal to mu 0 H minus M. H is equal to mu 0 B plus M. So these three are not correct. This first one is correct. The magnetic susceptibility is defined as. So when we place magnetic material in the external magnetic field, it is magnetized, and we know magnetization of the material is proportional to magnetic intensity. So M is equal to some proportionality constant into H. So this xi M we can write, it is magnitude of M upon magnitude of H. This xi M is called magnetic susceptibility. It is called magnetic susceptibility. So xi m is ratio of m upon h. Magnetic magnetization to magnetic intensity. So the magnetic susceptibility is defined as the ratio of magnetization to magnetic induction. This is incorrect. The ratio of magnetic induction to magnetization, this is also incorrect. Here we have induction. Product of magnetic intensity and magnetization, this is also incorrect. The ratio of magnetization to magnetic intensity, this is correct one. So the last one is correct. You may have asked question on unit of xi m. What is unit of xi m? So if we see xi m is m upon h, and if we go to this equation, if we go to this equation, see b is equal to mu 0 in bracket h plus m. So h and m will have the same unit. Now h is ampere per meter, so m will be ampere per meter. So both will have the same unit. So xi m will be unitless, no unit. So it is dimensionless also. The relation between magnetic intensity and magnetic induction in the magnetic material is B is equal to mu into H, where mu is equal to mu 0 in bracket 1 plus xi m, B mu is equal to mu 0 upon xi m, C B is equal to mu 0 in bracket 1 minus xi m, D mu is equal to mu 0 in bracket xi m minus 1. Which one is correct? Now xi m is magnetic susceptibility. Mu 0 is magnetic permeability of free space. Now let us take this equation. B is equal to mu 0 in bracket h plus m. So we know B is equal. We know B is equal to mu 0 in bracket h plus m. But what is m? So if we take B is equal to mu 0 in bracket h, m is what? Xi m into h. So I can write mu 0 in bracket 1 plus xi m multiplied by h. Now xi m is dimensionless, so 1 plus xi m, this is called as mu 0 into mu r h b, and this mu is called mu. Mu r is called relative permeability, xi m is susceptibility. So mu is what? Mu 0 into 1 plus xi m. So this first one is correct. Now the relation between xi m and relative permeability, just we have seen, we have taken this mu r as 1 plus xi m. So here mu r equal to 1 plus xi m is correct, other three are incorrect. The permeability of magnetic material is, just we have seen, mu is equal to mu 0 1 plus xi m. This is also called mu 0 into mu r. Mu r is relative permeability. So this second one is correct. Now next, a magnetic liquid is filled in U-tube and placed one arm in the region between poles N and S of the magnets as shown in figure. The level is depressed in the arm as shown in figure. Then the liquid is. So before placing in the magnetic field, we know there is magnetic field here. Before placing the placing in magnetic field, the levels will be equal. But when you place like this, level is depressed, means this liquid is repelled, and the material which is weakly repelled in magnetic field is called diamagnetic material. So here this liquid will be diamagnetic liquid. So this one is correct. Suppose if you have situation like this. Suppose means this level is increased, then what will happen? Suppose the level is increased, then what will happen? It is paramagnetic liquid. The materials which are weakly repelled in the external magnetic field are called diamagnetic materials. So this first one is correct. The materials which are weakly attracted in the external magnetic field are called diamagnetic material. Sorry, paramagnetic material, weakly attracted. They are called paramagnetic materials. Now, next one, a small bar magnet, bar is placed in the magnetic field between two pole pieces of magnet and it is oriented along the direction of magnetic field. Then the material of the bar is, means here, we have N and S, these are two poles, so we know there is magnetic field between these two. And suppose we place some bar here, and suppose that bar, it is oriented along the direction of field. Means here it is weakly attracted. So this material, it is paramagnetic. But if it is oriented like this, perpendicular to the magnetic field, then it will be diamagnetic. Diamagnetic. So it is oriented along the direction of magnetic field, so it is paramagnetic. For diamagnetic material, which of the following is correct? Magnetic susceptibility, xi m is less than 0, xi m is greater than 0, xi m is equal to 0, xi m is equal to 1. We know xi m, it is m upon h. And we know m, it is equal to xi m into h. Now what happens here? Diamagnetic material, it is magnetized opposite to the direction of magnetic field. So m is opposite to h, so xi m will be negative, so xi m will be less than 0, so xi m is less than 0, negative. For diamagnetic material, which of the following statement is correct? Now we know. What is mu? Mu r is relative permeability. We know mu r is equal to 1 plus xi m. But we know xi m is negative, less than 0. But it will be greater than minus 1. So what happens? 1 plus xi m. 1 plus xi m will be less than 1. It will be less than 1 mu r. Now next one, for paramagnetic material, which of the following is correct? For paramagnetic material, it is weakly attracted, so it is magnetized along the direction of field and its magnetic susceptibility is positive. Means here xi m is greater than 0. For magnetic material, xi m, it is greater than 0, but less than 1. Less than 1. For paramagnetic material, which of the following statement is correct? We are relative permeability. We have just seen Vr, it is 1 plus psi m. Psi m is greater than 0 but less than 1. Means we can write psi m less than 1, greater than 0. So what happens here? Mu r will be greater than 1. So mu r will be greater than 1. This is for paramagnetic materials. Which material have negative susceptibility? We have seen diamagnetic materials have negative susceptibility. Now next one, the hysteresis curve for ferromagnetic material is given as. This is hysteresis curve. Means initially we have non-magnetized ferromagnetic material. When it is placed in the external field, it goes on magnetizing along this direction. Then it goes to saturation. When we reverse the direction of applied intensity, it is demagnetized like this. Here we have point. So though external field reduces to zero, there is some magnetic field remains in, magnetization remains in the material. Then we change direction of H. For certain negative value of H, now P, magnetization inside the material becomes zero. Then it is magnetized along reverse direction. Then we change direction of magnetic intensity and we get curve like this. So here what is R? R, it is the magnetization remained in the magnetic field though external field is removed. And this point R, it is called retentivity. So the point R is called retentivity or reminiscence. And S is called coercivity or coercive force. The degree to which a magnetic material gains the magnetization after magnetizing force H is reduced to zero. The degree is called this one, that is retentivity. The value of residual magnetism Vr that gets zero with certain negative value of H, the value is called, if we see here, so here this is certain negative value of H for which this residual magnetic field becomes zero. This is called coercive force. So here, the second one is correct, coercive force. Now the area of BH curve is equal to. So whatever area, means here area is this area. This is called magnetization, no. Energy absorbed per cycle, no. Energy distributed per cycle of magnetization, S. This third one is correct. Reluctance, no. With an increase in area of hysteresis curve, means if area of hysteresis curve goes on increasing, then power loss will also increase. This one will also increase. Now the unit of retentivity is, now we have seen here, this is retentivity, that is remaining magnetization or magnetic flux density when h becomes 0. So this is along b. B has unit Weber per meter square. So retentivity will have also unit Weber per meter square. So here second one is correct, Weber per meter square. And unit of coercivity, it will be ampere per meter. Next one, the material used for permanent magnet should have, it must should have high retentivity, that is high reminiscence. The material suitable for making electromagnets should have, so whatever material, ferromagnetic material used in the electromagnets, it must be easily magnetized and demagnetized. So its BH curve should be like this. Means so here area loss must be very small. So whatever retentivity and coercivity, they must be low. So low retentivity and low coercivity. So this one is correct. So this is about multiple choice questions on magnetostatics. Now questions will be like this. You may have asked questions according to this pattern. Now in next lecture we will discuss electrodynamics. Thank you very much.